If you are looking to learn how to stash your changes in Git, you've come to the right place. In this video, we will cover how to perform Git stash, Git apply, and Git pop using a terminal, and then demonstrate how to perform these actions using GitKraken. Before jumping into how to perform a Git stash in the CLI, let's quickly go over what the Git stash command does. As the name suggests, Git stash is simply a way of, well, stashing your work. This is a great command to utilize when you need to temporarily and safely store your uncommitted local changes. To stash uncommitted local changes in Git, simply run the git stash command. This will put your working copy in a clean state and allow you to run different commands in Git, such as a checkout or pull. If you wish to see the contents of your most recent stash, you can run the command git stash show. Now, there might be a situation where you want to view the contents of an older stash you created. To do this, you will first need to run the git stash list command to get a list of all your repository stashes. Git will display all of your stashes and a corresponding stash index. To view the contents of a specific stash, you can run the command git stash show, followed by stash at, with the desired index. For the rest of the video, I'll assume we'll be working with the most recent stash, but feel free to utilize this syntax with other git stash commands as needed. So now that I've finished my other tasks in my repository, how do I go about actually getting my stash changes back? There are two ways to get your stash changes back in your working copy. If you want to get your changes back, but want to keep your stash around, you'll want to use the git stash apply command. This will take the changes of your most recent stash and apply them to your repository while preserving the stash. In the case that you want your stash changes but do not wish to keep your stash, you can utilize git stash pop. Similar to apply, this will apply your most recent stash to your repository, but will clean up the latest stash for you afterwards. Now that we've walked through how to stash changes in the CLI, we're going to review the simpler process of stashing changes with GitKraken. To stash your changes in GitKraken, you can simply click the stash button in the upper toolbar. A stash icon will appear in the graph to visually represent where your stash was created in your repository. Clicking on the stash will allow you to see its saved contents in the commit panel. You can also see a list of your stashes in the left panel under the stash section. To apply a stash in GitKraken, right-click the stash you wish to apply in the graph or in the left panel and select the apply stash option. To pop your most recently created stash in GitKraken, you can click on the pop button in the upper toolbar. If you wish to pop a specific stash, you can right-click the stash you want to pop in the graph or in the left panel and select the pop stash option. And that's it! If you liked the video, please subscribe to our channel or watch some of our other tutorials. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.